Through the way things are Your Heavenly Father, Thank you for giving us another beautiful Sunday where we can worship you together. Lord, it's been so long since we've started the online worship, but I thank you that we're now slowly able to gather together in person to worship you. I pray that as we start the transition process to come back to church, you will give us wisdom and patience so we may be able to do so safely for all of our church members. Now, no matter where we are physically, pray that your spirit be among us here and now, and that you will be glorified through our worship today. Now I pray for the planned church relocation. First, thank you for providing us with the beautiful place to worship. For the past years at this current sanctuary, we also firmly believe that you have already prepared for us another beautiful place of worship. We pray that you will give guidance and wisdom our church leaders and the task force team are leading the efforts, and that they will experience your walking in firsthand, and that they will be attentive to your voice and obey and follow your direction only. Pray for this pandemic to be over soon, as many of us are getting worn out physically, mentally, or even spiritually. We ask that you will give wisdom to those who are developing vaccines and cures for the virus, so that we may soon have proper vaccination and medication to provide relief for our soul. Even through this difficult time, please let us not forget that everything is under your control, and help us seek your will. Rely on you even more. We also pray for the upcoming Acts virtual conference. Thank you for sending us a great guest speaker in Dr. Aronson. Please equip him with your spirit and grant him the power and energy as he delivers your message to our church. I pray that this will be a time of restoration for those of us who are weary, as well as of encouragement for all of our church members as we navigate through this challenging time. Now I lift up many missionaries and their family members who have devoted their lives to you and are pouring out everything that they have in the mission field, even during this time of pandemic. Especially I lift up missionaries generally serving in Asia. Daniel and Helmi Choi in Guatemala. Young Kim in Redwood City. And then the IMB missionaries and Pastor Peter in GLP and Heritage Home Ministries. Please remember them. Would you please equip them with health and all the necessary resources and fill them with your spirit so they may not grow weary, but be stronger and more courageous in spreading the good news of Jesus Christ in their mission field every day. Or lastly, I lift up Pastor Joseph to you as he delivers your message today. Please fill him with your spirit as he delivers the word of God, and I pray that our hearts will be the good soil to really understand and accept those words, and our hearts and lives may be transformed. Love you and thank you. Please receive all the glory and honor to our worship. In the name of our Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Welcome to worship this morning. Is it okay if we kind of come in the middle? it'd be helpful because I can't really look at the camera and see like everybody. Thank you so much. It helps to focus and to see each other as worship. Obviously, I can't see you, but in spirit, we're worshiping together. Praise the Lord that the Lord has allowed us to worship indoors safely. And we have all these stickers here in the sanctuary where you can sit. Safe distance and sanitized and everything. So feel free to come to church. And I praise the Lord that we are having our Bible conference next weekend, and God has allowed us to meet together limitedly, but we're able to meet. So praise the Lord that just the right time God has allowed us for our county. So please remember that we have the virtual conference, but we, again, We are also meeting here in person on Sunday, so you're welcome to join for that. Want to remind you of the schedule. You'll be able to hear the conference on Friday night and Saturday night at 7 p.m. On Sunday, it'll be at 10 a.m. Evening sessions will have English subtitles, so you have no problem understanding what the speaker says. And we've added one more thing. There will be a Zoom call next Sunday during the Bible study. So usually you discuss the Sunday material. You'll have the time to ask questions and some insights after you've heard all the messages from Friday evening to Sunday. And you'll have some time to interact with the Pastor Aaron Song. So I asked him a favor, and this extra for him, and I asked him if he could join the Zoom call so that we can have a conversation around the Book of Acts. So look forward to that. And if you have hard questions, don't ask me, ask him at that time. That's your chance to ask the Dr. Paul. He knows so much about Book of Acts and Paul and Peter and all these witnesses. So let's come in. Let's prepare in prayer. We have the Children's Fall Festival coming up next Saturday, I believe. So the 31st, not this coming Saturday, but the week after that, the 31st of October, we're having a safe fall festival in the parking lot. So contact Pastor May if you'd like to attend, and if you haven't already, please contact her. So that's it for announcements. Let's go to the Word of God together. Today we are in the Book of Acts, chapter 13. Verses 1, 2, 3, and then 44 to 52. I selected the reading from the front end of chapter 13 and the back end of chapter 13, which means we're going to look at the whole chapter. So if you have Bibles, don't rely upon your screens, but have a Bible in hand as we worship the Lord together. I'll read these verses and just follow along with your ears and your eyes. Verse 1 of chapter 13 to 3. Now there were in the church at Antioch prophets and teachers, Barnabas, Simeon who was called Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manaen, a lifelong friend of Herod the tetrarch, and Saul. While they were worshiping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, set apart for me Barnabas and Saul for the work to which I have called them. Then after fasting and praying, they laid their hands on them and sent them off. Let's get to verse 44, the latter part of this chapter. The next Sabbath, almost the whole city gathered to hear the word of the Lord. But when the Jews saw the crowds, they were filled with jealousy and began to contradict what was spoken by Paul, reviling him. And Paul and Barnabas spoke out boldly, saying, it was necessary that the word of God be spoken first to you, since you thrust it aside and judge yourselves unworthy of eternal life. Behold, we are turning to the Gentiles, for so the Lord has commanded us, saying, I have made you a light for the Gentiles, that you may bring the salvation to the ends of the earth. And when the Gentiles heard this, they began rejoicing and glorifying the word of the Lord. And as many as were appointed to eternal life believed. And the word of the Lord was spreading throughout the whole region. But the Jews incited the devout women of high standing and the leading men of the city, stirred up persecution against Paul and Barnabas, and drove them out of their district. But they shook off the dust from their feet against them, and went to Iconium. And the disciples were filled with joy and with the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Well, a happy ending to the episode of Paul. I want to start off with a story that I recently experienced. Me and my wife love grapes. You know, those Korean kind of black grapes, the conquered grapes type. You know, that's the good thing is about these grapes is that you can have those here in California, Northern California. There are growers of conquered grapes. The problem is that they are so expensive, right? And another problem is my whole family loves these grapes. So if you buy a box of grape, which is like close to $20, I think, it lasts only like 2-3 days and it's gone. The whole box is gone. We love grapes. So there was a dilemma. How can we have, like, you know, plentiful, abundant grape in summer. Is that possible to have grapes? So we're looking for a bargain sale day, you know? You go to the Korean market and they say they sell these grapes. And we miss it sometimes. So we miss that sale. And sometimes when it's on sale, there's a lot of mold on there. You know, fungus. So it's like, it's not edible. So we tried something new this year, this summer.